Hey guys, Ayumi here with a new video on Hooked Inc. I know it's been some time since my last video on Hooked, but to be honest, there's not really that much stuff for me to do in this game anymore. I actually haven't progressed anything since my last video. They haven't released any new content to progress on. So the only thing they did release was two new fish. But they are both part of the Blowspike and Sharkulus. They're both part of the new daily bonus login program that they launched, which is really good. But that's on day 15 and day 30, I think, is where you get these two new fish. Regarding these three fish, I have no idea how to get them. No one I know knows how to get them. My best bet is that they are somehow in the transitional phase between each zone, when you go from one zone to another. Maybe at nighttime, maybe with wearing special items on. Honestly, I have no idea. I haven't bothered too much with them anymore. I'm also stuck on quest 48 or goal 48. Collect 300 stars. I have collected 240. I am missing out on 12 stars. It seems 12 stars, so that would get me up to 252, which means it's still impossible to complete goal 48. Other than that, I have noticed a lot of activity on my former Hooked Inc. videos, especially the Insane Income Boost video. It has almost 20,000 views now, so thanks everyone for watching my videos. But one of the questions I seem to get the most when reading and replying to all of your comments on these videos is about gems. How do I get gems as a free-to-play player? Well, there's three ways. Number one, you can get these chests. If you have the mechanic crew member, you can leave your boyos while leaving the game AFK overnight while you're sleeping, etc. And it will collect chests, item boxes, and shipments for you. You can see my usual boyo placement right here, by the way. This is where I usually place them. The number two thing is tournaments. You can get a fair amount of gems from the tournaments, especially if you win or come second place. But the best way is, of course, farming adds at the lucky wheel. So the average on the lucky wheel is 3 gems per ad. The reason for this is if you get 2x, it gives you 3 gems in the jackpot. If you get 3, you get 2 in the jackpot, 1 in your personal possession, in your gem bank, whatever you want to call it. If you get 4x, you get 2 in the jackpot, 1 in your own gem possession. And if you get the jackpot, it will give all the gems in the jackpot over to your personal gem bank, your own gem possession, but it will also add 3 gems to the next jackpot. So the average is 3 gems per ad. As for ad length, they vary between like 12 to 15 seconds at the shortest, maybe even shorter, all the way up to 30 seconds at most. So I think we can be fair to say that the average ad time is roughly 30 seconds. Just it actually might be shorter than that, but let's just go with 30 seconds because there's no way it's going to be higher than 30 seconds over a longer period of time. It's definitely going to be shorter, but still, let's just for the sake of it go with 30 seconds as the average time between each ad, and 3 gems is the average amount of gems per ad. So this means if you watch ads for 1 hour straight, you will get on average 360 gems. For 2 hours, 720 gems. For 3 hours, 1,080 gems, etc. If you watch 1 hour every day, then you do this for 4 weeks straight, you will get 10,080 gems. That's over 10,000 gems from 1 hour each day for a month. You can do 2 hours a day for 2 weeks. Or you can even do 4 hours a day for 1 week. Or if you're completely bonkers like myself, you can do 8 hours a day for like 3.5 days. Or you can even go higher. This is very boring. It's very tiresome. It requires a certain type of persistence and perseverance. And it's basically just a grind. You need pure fucking dedication to be able to do this. But if you really want it, there's nothing stopping you. It's like a grind in any other game. If you've played World of Warcraft, you had to grind monsters, raids, whatever, for XP, at least in the old days when I used to play it. In any game, there's some kind of grind. In this game, the grind is watching ads. The good thing is, if you like Hooked Inc., you think it's a good game, then you have two ways of contributing to the game developers. Number one, you can use your real life money to buy this shit, saving you a lot of time. Or if you want to play free to play like me, then you have to farm ads. The good thing is you will actually benefit the game developers and support them for making this awesome game by doing this, as well as getting free stuff yourself. The best tactic I've found for farming games this way is one of two things. Number one, you can do this in coalition with the insane income boost trick. So every time you get a 3x or 4x, you wait for a shiny tiger to spawn and you use the rush time mechanic to get a bunch of money and progress. And then you go back to watching ads until you get a 3x or 4x again, etc. This will slow down the ad income, but it will give you some sort of variation. Or the best tip, which is just do something a bit brain dead, like watch TV, watch a movie, watch a TV show, whatever, anything that doesn't really require your attention too much. Because then you can just sit and click on these ads every 20 to 30 seconds and just keep watching ads. It's pretty brain dead to do, to be honest. It's just about the dedication to do it. So, yeah, you should easily be able to farm 10,000 gems in 2 weeks just by doing this for 2 hours a day. If you think that's too much, that the grind is too much for you, then maybe it's not worth it for you. It's just as simple as that. So that's how to farm games. As far as Hooked Inc. goes, I don't think there's anything new on the agenda. I think I've covered most of the new stuff. They haven't released any new zones. They haven't released any new boats yet. So I'm just waiting for new content. The reason I'm not playing this game anymore, which I could leave my phone on overnight to increase my fishing XP, etc. This way I would be a monster when the new content got out and I would clear it immediately. But to be honest, I like this game. I think it's pretty fun. So I kind of want to hold back on collecting more XP until they actually release content where I can progress some more. This way I will be able to actually play the game and not just instantly complete it when they release new content. As usual, feel free to leave a reply on my video or leave a comment. I will reply to every single comment I get. I'm steadily and slowly growing my channel and I hope to get more views. So thank you very much for watching these videos. I hope this helped you in either deciding how to get all the gems you want to get for the crew members, etc. Or maybe it made you realize it's just not worth it. That's completely up to you. Thanks for watching. Have a good one. Until next time. Bye.